Concept called garbage collection. What this garbage collection does actually? Garbage collection removes unused or unreferenced object from the memory, or you can call memory locations. And this task, who cares this task? This task will be taken care by garbage collector. This task will be taken care by garbage collector. Suppose if there is no garbage collector, what will happen? If there is no garbage collector, what will happen? All the dump, waste, everything will be collected. Everything will be dumped. Everything will be dumped in your RAM itself. And one or other time, your system need to get hang, right? Performance will get degraded out. So if any value is not useful with respect to your application, what you should do, or you, or on behalf of someone else, like Python virtual machines, what they should do? They should have to remove that value from the memory and make that memory locations or memory address freely available for other objects. If garbage is not collected, that object, that item value will remain in memory only itself. If new value I want to allocate in memory, if new object I want to create in memory, if there is no free memory space available for new objects, what other object has to do? They have to wait for unlimited number of times, and the performance get degrades, right? Performance degrades. So to overcome this issues, we have to take the help of garbage collector. So while executing the program, if garbage collections takes place, or garbage collections performs their basic operations like collecting the garbage values, garbage objects from the memory, then definitely your program performance, your execution of your program is become faster, because it will collect the unreferenced, unused objects or values from the memory. So who is responsible to create this garbage collection program? If you go for maximum object oriented programming language, every programming language contains inbuilt garbage collector. Garbage collector is a program like your normal program, whose responsibility is to count, number of objects are created and how many objects are being used. If any object reference is not being used, what they has to do? What garbage collector has to do? It has to unreference, it has to delete, right? So garbage collector is an inbuilt or predefined program which removes unreferenced or unused objects from the memory. So here, also garbage collector tracks every object for how many times it is referred. Suppose if I create the objects of a class for 10 object, 15 object, 20 object, 100 object. Okay, among 100 objects, if it reach that count, the specified threshold count, what garbage collector has to do? It will verify a tracker. Based on the tracker and time limits, it will remove the unnecessary memories and unused references from the memory. So the number of reference variables which are pointing to the objects is known as reference count. Means I created the reference guys memory, and number of addresses are pointing to that reference count is, or number of addresses or number of variables are pointing to that address are called as reference count or variable reference count. And that variable reference count, counting of those variable references, is the responsibility of garbage collector. Garbage collector will track all the records, how many objects are created for each class, until unless it won't cross that threshold value. If it cross that threshold value, it will search for less used object reference and it will vanish that object from the memory. Or if any object is in unused, someone need to track, na? If there is no tracker, what will happen? N number of objects will be created in memory. And one other time, your system will get hang, your RAM will get hang, and your system will get bust. And definitely your performance of your application will degrade. So while executing Python program, if any object reference count becomes zero, then internally Python interpreter calls that garbage collector, and garbage collector will remove that objects from the memory locations. If you take an example guys, here class demo, so it contains one method called m1, and I'm printing hello world. If you look at the pictorial representations, class demo def m1 self, I made a simple print statement hello world. Now I want to call this method one. What will happen? The reference count, look at here. Suppose if I execute this program on my shell prompt, so What will happen? See, just see. Let me go to my shell prompt. Because multiple indents. Just observe this output. I kar to me. Class demo. Next term, print hello world guys. That's it, right? D. Now look at here. One reference get created into memory. But how can I print the reference? D. So this is the address reference. This is the address reference. Now if you look at the diagram, if you look at the diagram, and if I point this diagram to here, so this is the address reference. This is the address reference. This address reference hold by D. Address reference hold by D. And this reference counter, if I use reference counter, will become zero. Becomes zero, right? Becomes zero. Now this memory locations, this memory location is allocated for D. Allocated for D. I call D.M1, then D will hold its memory locations. And its location contains any value? No. It does not contain anything. Suppose if I wrote one more statement, self.a initialized with 300. What will happen? In its memory locations, a initialized with the 300. A initialized with the 300. And the memory location is this. This is pointing by your D. And reference count will increase by 1. Because instantiation process already taken care by D assignment operator demo of, right? Object created, and this address is held by D. This address is held by D. 0x003f something 98. This is received by D, right? I perform my operations. Now I'm not performing any operations. Now someone need to track whether that object is in use or not. Then who we need to track? Garbage collector need to track. So when my program gets committed, I close my applications. Garbage collector in track for some seconds, some minutes. If that threshold value reach to exist, then garbage collector will vanish that object reference from the memory and will make the count as a zero. Reference count as a zero. Again if you call once again, what will happen? Same memory object will create. Again method will be called, again memory will be created. Understood? If you are looking for some note point about this, let me give for this diagram. We'll go for Dell also, not to worry. When we are creating some objects, it removes the first reference or first address. It removes the first address of D, or you can call D object, address of D object, and then place second address of D1. Let me create from here one more object reference, that is D1. Suppose if I write one more time D, or you can call D1 to the demo, right? Now D1 dot, if I call here D1 dot M1, what will happen about this line? One more object will be created into memory. This object contains A as a value as a 300. Whatever the address is given, that address will be pointing to your D1. Let me use some different color for your understanding sake. So this D1 will be pointed by this newly created reference, right? So whenever you try to create the new object reference, existing object reference removed, the reference count becomes zero, right? Now if you go for this reference count for newly created D1, so here reference count will be 1 again. reference point will be 1 again, because I'm working with new object. I'm working with the new objects. So then d1, then takes place in second address of d1. Now if you observe this diagram, what is the reference count again? Object created, reference count to 1. Now program closed, reference count to 0. Again program gets run, d1 new object created, now reference count is again 1, right? This is second time. Now for this case, now for d1 gets removed, and now the reference count becomes 0, or you can call here 0. Then the Python interpreter calls the garbage collector. And it removes that object from the memory locations. Now apart from this garbage collector, who is responsible to handle this garbage collection operations? One is destructor and second is del keyword. Let us see about destructor and del keyword.